नमस्ते।
यस नमस्ते सर, आई वांटेड टू आस्क यू दैट हाउ कैन वी मेक मैथ्स मोर इंटरेस्टिंग फॉर किड्स, बिकॉज पीपल आर रियली वेरी अफ्रेड ऑफ मैथ्स ऑल द टाइम. सो व्हाट आर द वेज वी कैन एंगेज किड्स मोर?
यू आर कॉल्ड कक्कोली.
यस.
सो व्हिच इज योर सब्जेक्ट?
My subjects are I passed with genetics, zoology and chemistry.
Zoology and chemistry. So your mathematics is up to 10th class?
Yes, till 12th I had maths. Yeah.
Even after BTech, when they go for a MNC company or any competitive exams like civil service, all of them find a difficulty in basic arithmetic.
Okay.
Because it's the speed in which you can compute matters. And we are talking in the context of National Mathematical Day, right?
Right.
So National Mathematics Day is with Srinivasa Ramanujan's birthday.
Yes.
And
okay.
That is declared by Prime Minister Manmohan Singh in his second term. I think that was in 2012.
Okay.
He declared 22nd December as Mathematics National Mathematics Day. I think you can just check these dates and such things.
Okay.
But before that, there was a International Mathematics Day, or that is what by mistake while typing you type it as international, right?
Yes.
There is an International Mathematics Day, and that happens to be March 14th.
Okay.
Do you know why is it March 14th?
No idea.
Yeah, these are all fun. Actually, this is how we must inculcate interest in mathematics in children. International Mathematics Day is on March 14th. Are you writing somewhere?
Yes.
Or recording?
Yeah, I'm also recording.
Okay. When you write, how do you write March 14th?
I write March, then 1/4.
How do you write March in number? Because mathematics is number, right?
Yeah. Okay. In a date format, I'll write 14/3.
But the Western, they will write as 3/14.
Yes. Right. Yeah.
3.14, right? Do you know what is 3.14 in mathematics? 3.14?
Pi.
Yeah.
Value.
So originally it was called Pi Day.
Okay.
There is no reason why March 14th is selected as Pi Day, just because it is 3.14.
Okay.
Is it not interesting?
Yes.
But I don't know how many mathematics teachers who are teaching mathematics knows this.
Yeah.
See, that is because they don't. Now I am 100% sure Kakoli will never forget this in your life, right?
Yes, right. I'm never going to forget.
You tell me how many teachers will teach mathematics like you. Now I am seeing Kakoli as my student. Now, how many teachers will teach like this?
Very few, sir. At least I didn't have very good teachers, I don't think.
I am a wonderful teacher. You tell me whichever subject you want, including your genetics.
That would be great, sir. I still have to learn a lot.
Just now I got one message from Ayodhya, one student. She wanted to prepare Indian Forest Service.
Okay.
They also contact me. So I have given the syllabus to her, told her you read this in case if you have doubt in any of this portion, you come back to me.
Right.
How courageously I am telling this. It is not my subject. I taught most of the topics in the world, including biotechnology, where I never learned biotechnology in my life. You know why?
How are you doing that, sir?
Yeah, that is because I look at everything in this world as mathematics.
Okay.
Because mathematics is the language of science. Mathematics is the language of nature. Mathematics is the language of social science. Mathematics is the language of life.
Okay, I don't know how do you draw a link between math and social science.
The whole universe is called the cosmos, right? The study of space, study of planets. Where you have one solar system and a lot of planets going around it. Is it not mathematics?
Well, yeah, in a way, yes.
So, when I'm explaining to you, I must tell about orbit. And that science is mathematics. Though it is physics, I cannot explain physics without mathematics. I have to tell something which is in my mind to get into Kakoli with the language that is what English is for now. But if I have to explain physics to you, I must use mathematics.
Right, yes.
Now that is a big space, the whole space in the world. And in which few planets are going around it. Now you tell me which planet which you like most.
I like Jupiter because it has many moons.
And you don't like the earth on which you are living.
I like it also. Obviously, I like Earth.
See, now you...
I can't live on Jupiter.
Yeah, now you said Jupiter. Immediately, you said it has got a lot of satellites around
it.
Correct? That means you took a set of satellites, connected with another set, and then you had some number associated with that. And you don't like Earth because it has only one satellite, which is Moon.
Yeah, we could do it more.
But we have many artificial satellites which are placed there. Therefore, Earth has got a maximum number of satellites.
Yeah, that's true.
Now, which... Now, tell me, I made your mind the way I wanted by arguing with you. Which language which I used? I used mathematics.
Yes. Yeah.
Understood?
Yes. Now, the moment you start talking about numbers, you're talking mathematics. So, yeah, more than, less than, fewer than,
See, everything in the world, if I want to make somebody happy, I want to make somebody sad, I will ask you how many years of experience you have.
Okay.
So, immediately I am connecting years, time and date, space, space. All these are related. I can explain to only person who understand mathematics. How fast you understand gives you a lot of logic. So, logic is mathematics. Mathematics is logic. I had session with the English senior teachers. Asked them to tell each word in English. I was director for Academic Staff College. Teaching teachers was my job under the UGC, University Grants Commission. So I must have taught more than 6 lakhs of teachers in this country. So I keep arguing with the English teachers, tell me a word, I will find mathematics in that. There is no word. There is no word in the world. Though I said mathematics is science communication language, other language which you use for anything is English, other than science. That also contains a lot of mathematics inside.
How can you connect to any word?
You tell me any word, I will tell you now, right now.
Caterpillar.
Caterpillar is what? Is it a small,
like a bug.
Small and animal or a small fly? Okay, how many legs it has? Do you want to explain it to you? Will you have to use mathematics or not?
True, that's true.
Yeah, the figure, the size, the shape, everything you have to explain through mathematics only, ma.
Your
land is Assam. What is Assam?
Yes. It is a state in
No,
South
what is the
India.
meaning of Assam?
Assam means home, means like it's not leveled.
Not samam. Samam is equal.
Samam
is a Sanskrit word. Samam is equal. So Assam means not equal. Is not equal is a mathematics?
Right, it is.
So you tell me either it is a noun or a word or a verb or a adjective, anything is mathematics.
That's very interesting way to look at it.
So now tell me, if I teach this in the young children, will they not feel love towards mathematics?
They do, they will.
See, that is why I keep challenging to people, saying that if somebody says mathematics is not their liking, send it to me for half an hour, I will make them to love mathematics.
Sir, can you explain things like calculus and trigonometry?
Okay, now tell me, what is trigonometry? Okay, you want higher class. What is trigonometry?
I really don't know very clearly.
Yeah, it generally comes in the 9th, 10th, 11th, 12th class, depends on the syllabus and where you are, right? So most of the people find trigonometry very difficult. Now I will make anyone who understands little bit of mathematics to enjoy trigonometry so easily. Okay, now tell me, if I have to looking at the ground, I am using a telescope to see the top of a big building on which you are wanted to see the top floor. Am I looking through a pipe to focus something?
Yeah, right.
It can be a telescope or it can be a small pipe also, right?
Yeah.
So
yes, it can be.
Now, if I have to see on top, I have to tilt it from 0 degree to maybe 45 degree. Correct or not?
Yes.
If it is on my height, I will put it at 0 degree. And if it is little higher, I will put it at 15 degree. Little more higher, I will put it at 45 degree.
Right.
Correct. So angle will tell me, and assume that the building is very close to me or very far from me, I have to change the direction, the angle, right?
Yes, right.
If it is, I am standing very close to the building to look on the top of the building, I will have to look at 90 degree. If it is little far, 45 degree is good enough.
Yeah.
Is it not trigonometry? Angle and side. Relation between, generally when we talk about a trigonometry, we only talk about the sine, cos straight away we start the class. I don't have to start it. You know, how is it saying? If I am looking parallel, I have zero tilt. If I am looking 90 degree, it is one tilt. Say it is one. Okay. Now, how do I relate between zero tilt to zero to 90 degree as one? I define a function which is called a sine function. So, if it is half, that means 45 degree, I will call it as 1 by 2. Or 1 by root 2. Whatever number I want, I can add it to that and then create a function. That is how function is related. Suppose if I want to the opposite of that, 90 degree when I look at it, it is 0. 0 degree it becomes 1. That becomes cos function. The other becomes sine function.
Okay.
And trigonometry is not triangle business, because I am talking about in which direction I look at it. Which direction I can look at it? 360, 0 to 360. So it is actually 0 to 360 we learn in circle. Correct.
Okay.
So that is why I have got sine, cos functions defined from 0 degree to 360 degree. Then I don't have to discuss, because my function is between 0 to 90. I can always divide by pi, pi by 2, and then redefine the function accordingly. That is why relations in sine and cos will always come with the pi plus, pi by 2 plus, etc., etc. It comes. There pi is the angle. 2 pi is 180 degree, pi, pi by 2 is 90 degree, etc., etc. You'll have to learn. So you have the concept of degree, 0 to 360 degree, that becomes so simple to learn. But most of the teachers don't tell the relation between triangle and circle, relation between side, my side.
Yeah.
No?
Yeah. That's true. Yeah, yeah. And they don't explain anything at all, at least in my time. Yeah.
Everywhere, even today. You understood. See, I had a class for geography teachers. I'm basically from Kerala. I had a class for geography teachers in Alappi.
Okay.
Telling them, if you don't know mathematics, your geography class is boring. If you know mathematics, your geography class becomes so simple and interesting, because we learn a time difference between, now trigonometry is over, eh? Yeah.
Right.
Now assume that you want to know the time difference between Assam and Hyderabad. Actually, time difference is not there, but you
not
know
there.
The daylight difference is there.
Daylight. Yeah. That's like
correct.
3 hours. Yeah.
And in I also stayed in I used to go to Arunachal Pradesh for children. Tezpur and all these places I stayed in my life. One of my sister's daughter's name is Dimu. Because she took birth in Dimapur.
Yeah,
Rengia railway station and all that northeast railway station tea stall was owned by my brother-in-law. He was health inspector for the railways.
Okay.
So I have a close relation. So
yeah,
I keep.
So you have, you know the background is where I come from.
So I keep traveling to Arunachal Pradesh to talk to children there, to educate them. They used to come and touch me after the class. And I asked them, why are you touching? Because they wanted to go back to their home and tell that they touch the Indian space scientist.
That must
feel
so great.
See, because rarely they will see somebody who is traveling to that northeast corner from the southwest corner from Kerala. I used to travel there, spend 10 days.
Up to Amiliang,
the China border, schools where I go. And you are disconnected because no BSNL, no electricity. You know such places, right?
Yes.
So I keep telling them, you can send me a message when the BSNL wind will come. Once in a while only it comes. See?
Yes, I know. It is like that.
The geography, when I speak, the whole earth is 360 degree equatorial plane.
Yes. Yeah.
That is revolving in 24 minutes. 24 hours. So 24 hours will become 24 into 60.
Yeah.
24 into 60 is 4 into 6 into 60.
Yes. Yeah.
Now, do you agree it is 4 into 360?
4 into 360 is...
Yeah, because 4 into 6 into 60 is 24 hours.
Okay.
So, it is 4 minutes, 60 times is 24 hours. Hello, 360 times.
Yeah.
4 minutes, 360 times. Now I am dividing the earth, the time of 24 hours into 4 minutes and 360 minutes. 360 times, repeat 4 minutes.
Okay, got it. Yeah.
You know why I am doing it? Because 360 degree, the earth rotation happens in 24 hours, means 1 degree must be in 4 minutes. Now, you must have learned in your geography, 1 degree difference is 4 minutes. That is why the time difference happens along longitude.
Okay. I have understood this now.
Now, tell me, how many geography teachers will know the way I told you now? How many geography students would have learned like this? Nobody will teach like this. Nobody will learn like this. So what is lacking is, you have to imagine. You have to visualize.
Right.
When you visualize things becomes clear for you.
Yes.
That you have to understand, not learn.
Right.
There is lot of difference between learning and understanding.
It is there, yes.
You learned 1 degree is 4 minutes. Mm-hmm. Is different from understand 1 degree is 4 minutes.
Yes, true. And they used to tell us to learn it, you know, by heart, and we never understood what is the
knowledge. I will also tell you, Kakoli has to learn by heart.
Hmm.
But learn by heart. Don't learn by heart, but learn by heart.
Hmm.
There is a difference between learn by heart and learning by heart, right?
Hmm.
Your heart, your manas is fully with me. That is why you are able to learn mathematics without seeing, without writing, without... I am just explaining like this, right?
Yes.
I have taken mathematics class to MSc Mathematics 6 hours non-stop without chalk and board.
Wow, that's amazing.
And ask questions on all those topics. I'm 100% sure Kakoli will answer exactly the way I explained to you all that concept which I taught you so far.
I really hope that this is giving me so much of confidence.
See, that is
because I've been always afraid of math, and that is why I left it.
No, that is because I'll tell you, most of the children don't like a subject because the teachers are useless.
Yes, that's true. That I realize now.
Now, not this. I can teach you English probably much better than any English teachers. Same way. Because I am not teaching subject, I am teaching how to learn. I am teaching how to learn, that's it. See, Aryabhata is the first person who understood what is pi.
Right.
What he did was, he took a circle, divided that into 6 pieces, and then found that one of the piece you put it, it becomes the radius. So he defined the circumference of a circle is 6 times the radius. But later, Lambert from Germany in 17th century, he identified it is 2 pi r. But 2 pi is close to 6, no?
Yeah, right.
You understood?
Yes.
And Aryabhatiyam, he wrote, Shat Bhagajya Vishkamba Arthena Satulya. That's the Sanskrit sloka. Shat Bhagajya means 1/6. Bhagam means portion. Shat means 6. 6 portion. Vishkamba means circumference. So Vishkamba, circumference, Ardhena, half of that. Is what the radius is, the half of that, the diameter, half of that will become the radius, and that is 1/6 of the circumference. Satulya, that is equal. That is equal. That's what he said.
Sir, what was pi r square? What was that? That was diameter. What area?
No, 2 pi r. The pi r square is the area.
Right. Okay.
Now, I have a scale with me. Okay, let me check. I have a picture. I will send you that picture also.
Okay.
The scale, what I did was, I took a 1 feet scale. The aluminium one, no? The steel one. I buy the Chinese fellow. Chinese fellow is not very stiff. Very cheap quality, right?
Yes.
Then, in one side you will see generally one hole.
Yes.
But both side I made holes.
Okay.
I took a nail and then hammered it, made a small nut and bolt, connected all the 4 together.
Okay.
So what do I get? I get a square. Because all the side by side is 1 feet, 1 feet, 1 feet, right? Suppose if I make that like a square, and make to pass through your head downward. Your head will go. But it will stuck after your shoulder, right?
Right, yes.
because your perimeter is bigger than 4 feet.
Yeah, yeah, right. Yeah, yeah. But for a kid, it will go.
No, it will not go.
No. For a kid, like very, very small child.
Yeah, small child. It will go. Yeah, but now you are a small child for me.
Okay.
Now what I will do is
longer scale, sir.
No, 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 not required. The same scale which is connected, I can just tilt and make a circle out of it. I can just pull it to one side and make an ellipse out of it. And in one place what I do is, I will keep one nut and bolt I will remove and connect a stick through that, or maybe a aerial, broken aerial I used to use. And then pass through that like a string sort of a thing and connect them and rotate it perfectly well. And it will be like a globe rotating around a. Are you seeing it, my dear?
So I'm thinking, if you have to make an ellipse, then there should be only two scales, no? Or you need the four scales?
See, the same square, I am just tilting it in such a fashion, I will get a scale out. I mean, get a rotation out of it.
Yes.
See, then it becomes a circle, right?
Yes.
Four scales, so I can connect and make a circle also. I'll send you a picture, then you will understand perfectly.
Yeah.
In some college I was teaching teachers, I think that picture is there with me.
No, I got it now.
With the two holes, if I just pass through a stick, then it is like how the globe is placed. And then you rotate it along the equator, definitely there will be a bulging on the poles.
Yes.
Anything which you rotate in the direction of the rotation, there is a there is a pushing from the top and bottom.
Yes.
Now that is the shape of Earth.
Right.
Now that shape of Earth, like a little pulled from both the side, I am making an ellipse. And now I will pass with these 4 feet circumference, and I can pass through Kokoli.
Yes, you can.
On a square, I cannot, but I can just make it a circle, same scale, same. I did not change that circumference, only shape changed. So when I change the shape, area changes.
Right.
Circumference need not change. Is it not a great learning of mathematics?
Yeah, it is very interesting. Yes.
Now tell me, many people will learn algebra, geometry, equations, but they don't visualize.
Yes. And they're like, as you said, they're not taught to do it, you know?
Yeah, they're, not to do. Yeah, see, for example, how do I teach history? I will draw one line and put 0 there and put BC and AD. What is BC and AD? I am a person in BC. Is it I am a person in BC?
No, but you were imagining.
Yeah, because I am before computers. The present world is after digital.
that's a good definition.
And now what is ABCD? ABCD. Between AD is what BC is. Between AD is what BC is. Whatever is in BC can be explained using AD. The whole history I can put it on a number line. And then put, see, for example, Srinivasa Ramanujam. You know, how do I remember dates? I will remember this date when Kokoli spoke to me last next year. If you are on WhatsApp with me, I will send a message 20th, 2020, wow. December 21st, we met you.
How do you do that?
I number them as 20, 12, 21 and then put it in my box.
Your box.
Yeah, either memory box or my window box,
Okay.
doesn't matter. 2020, 2019, December 18th, I spoke to Manju.
Okay.
19th,
Okay.
my article came on Indian Express. Have you
Ah.
seen that article at least?
Yes, I've seen that.
Yeah, before that, I met Manju when first time when I was in a TEDx lecture in Vignan, where she was also a TEDx lecture, I was also a TEDx lecture.
Okay.
Okay, like this, we relate the date and time. Now, when I know March 2019-14, March 1914, 1914, Ramanujan went to England.
Okay.
How do I remember it? I know 1 year after that, Mahatma Gandhi came to India.
Okay. So you, okay. I remember the events like that. Okay.
Now, do I relate things like this? Is it simple?
It's like you are associating it with some other thing,
Yeah, now I will tell you.
considering that.
The year I took birth, Nehru died. The year I joined for my master's, Indira Gandhi died. Either I got a job that year, Rajiv Gandhi died.
Your progress in life does not, bode well
See,
for other people.
Nayalu Kakoli, you will never forget this year in your life. I am telling you like this only, no?
This one I'm going to remember. Like there is a Hindi horror movie called 1920. Now I'll remember this like that.
Yeah, 1920, Srinivasa Ramanujan died in 33 years. So you can subtract 33, and you remember 1887 was Ramanujan's birth. So everything is relational. Whole history is relating to years. If you are good in
That's true.
mathematics, now I know Swami Vivekananda met Ramakrishna and they were together 6 years. After that, Ramakrishna died. And immediately you know the sequence in the life of Vivekananda. It becomes so simple, no?
Yes, that's true.
Is it not?
Yes.
So, which year he went to? See, now Ramanujam went when he was, what age is good enough? Then the rest of the things will fall in line, no? One year before he came back, actually, then he was sick. Ramanujam used to relate with the numbers like this. You know which is Ramanujan's number?
No,
Yeah,
I
that is also called Hardy number. Hardy was the professor. Where what Ramanujan did was, you imagine those days there was no other communication. He wrote a huge letter. And that letter was, I think, approximately 120 pages. Okay. And he wrote this to Hardy, and Hardy took 1 or 2 days to understand with his colleagues. And immediately he rated Ramanujam out of a scale of 100. Ramanujam can be rated as 100%. Hardy is only 25, he said. So he is meeting somebody who is much, much better knowledgeable than him. He found that, no, I want, and probably the best mathematician who was in that period around England was never rated as more than 75. So that is where he decided, I am going to be a person who will hand take care of Ramanujam if he comes here. And then he came, and not only as a professor, not only as a researcher, not only as a guide and a mentor. When Ramanujam was sick in the hospital, Hardy visited him, and through the window Ramanujam saw the taxi number, and that taxi number was 1729. And that number is called a taxi cab number. That number is also called a Srinivasa Ramanujam Hardy number.
Oh, okay.
And when he was sick, immediately Hardy, Ramanujam told Hardy, your number is beautiful because that is the number which two cube numbers, addition of two cube numbers in two different ways can be put together, and that is the smallest such number in the number system. Because 1729 is equal to 1 cube plus 12 cube.
Okay.
And that is also equal to 9 cube plus 10 cube.
Achha.
So two different cubes added together will become 172929, and that is the smallest such number available.
And he just looked at a number and he gets,
you know, that
could understand. That's crazy.
You understood. So that was his brilliance. I think that is why that point of time Hilbert was the, we learn in mathematics Hilbert space and all that. That's a beautiful mathematical concept. Hilbert was only probably 75 or 80 was the rank in which he can, I mean the scale in which he can be put as 85, where Ramanujam was put at 100. So meeting such a wonderful person like Hardy was, and you know, Hardy was not even a mathematician, he was also a biologist. He had a lot of contribution in your field, genetics.
Maybe I had read it, but I can't recall that now. But yeah.
See, every subject is not different. What I am trying to say is, when people ask me, the other day I gave a career guidance program for Saudi Arabia.
Okay.
I almost every day I post one video, okay, YouTube. And yesterday's I posted, and today's will be another half, 1 hour lecture will be on that. Somebody asked microbiology, what is the scope today?
Okay.
I said microbiology scope is lost. That is because it is microbiology. Micro is what? 10 power minus 6. What is micro? 10 power minus 6, correct?
Yes.
You look at the cell more detail with a larger microscope, that is 10 power minus 6 times. You can zoom it to 10 power 6 times of a meter, then you look at the micro level.
Right.
That is what is called the microbiology.
Yes.
But people found a better microscope which can be seen 10 power minus 9. That become nanotechnology. So what is nano? 10 power minus 9.
Right.
So 10 power minus 9, if I can see things up to that detail, why should I stop at minus 9, minus 6 and talk about DNA may have this pattern? I can say DNA has this pattern.
Yeah.
That is how the protein is reacting.
Yes.
That is how the, no? See, it all depends on what level I can see will define the development of biology. So therefore microbiology lost its relevance and nanotechnology took its part. And people who must have learned nanotechnology, PhD also, I speak to them practically showing them nanotechnology. What is nanotechnology? What is that today? Where you can see nanotechnology? You have sufficient mosquitoes around you?
Yes.
Mosquitoes will take blood from you.
Yep.
They are using needle.
Yes.
Why our doctors are not able to use a needle like that to take blood from your body or give an injection medicine? Because we don't have the mechanism of creating such a needle as micro, nano, as a mosquito needle.
Right.
Now you understand the relevance of nanotechnology, no?
Yes. I do.
Now I have to
remember this.
I have to cut a cell I have to remove three cells which is cancerous in my body somewhere. To remove that, I need to make a big hole.
Yeah.
That is because I don't have an equipment which is as nano as possible in my hand. If I have a nano needle with me, I would have taken through a smaller hole. I would have just plucked in only that cell which has got a problem instead of cutting the whole organ.
Yeah.
Is it mathematics or not?
Yes.
This is biology, but with biology understanding in the different scale.
Even medicine doses are mathematics.
Yeah, that is why you cannot learn any science without the strong help of this. But you cannot learn this at the highest level. You must be able to think in this direction. That thinking ability is given to you in the childhood by learning geometry. That's why geometry is introduced.
Right.
But we don't teach that geometry in that sense.
Yes.
Suppose you have a cylinder, small cylinder. What is the circumference of the cylinder? 2 pi r. We just learned, no? 2 pi r. That is the circumference. That's only a circle. But only thing, the circle has got a bigger, long side that becomes the height of the cylinder. Now I will cut the cylinder and make it into, open it up. It will become a rectangle, no?
If you cut the cylinder...
I cut the cylinder, let it that the cylinder be like a pipe. I will cut that. Vertically I am cutting. That height wise I am cutting.
Yeah.
So it is not a pipe.
I can spread it.
That becomes a rectangle, right?
Right.
So what is one side there? 2 pi r.
Yeah.
And the other side is h. So what is the area of that rectangle which I get? 2 pi r into h. So what is the surface area of a cylinder? We learn 2 pi r h. But I am sure no teacher will tell you 2 pi r into h is the circumference of the cylinder. You have to make it by heart.
Yes, exactly. That is the whole problem.
Why do you want to by heart it? You cut it and then spread it and show them once.
Yeah.
See, that showing is not happening. That is the problem. You understood?
Yes.
Now, what is... what is 20...
So you're saying that there's a lot of stress on rote learning and we're not taught, given live examples from life or practical examples.
Yeah, this is how it is to be taught. See, I am teaching you now mathematics, geometry, trigonometry, everything, even without we are meeting each other, na?
Right.
Now, assume if I can show this cut and show, it will become, and I will ask you to cut and see yourself. That's good enough.
Yeah.
Now tell me, what is multiple of 28 into 32?
I don't know.
You know. You know. Any person who don't like maths also know a minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square.
Right.
You heard this, right? A minus b into a plus b is equal to a square minus b square. Everybody must have learned this in childhood.
Yeah.
But tell me, where is it used in your life?
Yes, I don't know. I have wondered about this.
Now, just now I am giving you a question. 28 into 32.
Okay.
That is 30 minus 2 into 30 plus 2.
Okay.
30 minus 2 into 30 plus 2 is 30 square minus 2 square.
Right.
30 square is 900. 2 square is 4. 30 square minus 9. So it becomes 896. Is it not simple?
Wow, I ideally didn't know this curve.
See, when I used to have that mathematics teachers workshop and all, I asked them small questions. they will immediately take calculator. You know, any competitive exam, the time given for answering these questions are only 40 seconds. Where even if you use calculator to type it, it will take 40 seconds. But I can do it much faster because I am using a mental scope which is much higher than any other scope. So, this is imagination. This is visualization. This is logical reasoning. This is analytical skill. These are all what is essential for anyone to get into the core of mathematics. Now, assume somebody says they don't like mathematics. Now, you tell me, I've got, Kakoli, I will give you the 2021 calendar to you. Okay?
Okay.
400. Are you writing 400 as the number? That is January, February, March. Code number. 4 is January, 00 is February and March.
How?
No, I will tell you, explain you, but just write down this first.
Yeah.
400, 351,
351, okay.
362,
362,
and
402. Okay.
400, 351, 362, 402. Easy to learn because they themselves have got a rhythm of number. One is 400, last is 402. The between is 351 and 362.
Okay.
350 is 50 difference plus 1. Another one is another 11 added to that.
Right.
So what is the number now? Without looking, you can tell. 400, 351, 362, 402. See, I don't have anything in front of me. I'm just saying blah, blah, blah to you. Now tell me, January is 4, I divide it like a quarter. 400 is for January, February, March, 351 for April, May, June, 362 for July, August, September, October, November, December is 402.
Okay.
So December is 2.
Right.
January
right.
is 4.
Right.
August is 6.
Yes.
Now tell me, when is Kakoli's birthday?
Mine is 1st August.
1st August. So August, number is 6, right?
Six.
Add 6 to that date. 1 plus 6 is 7.
Add
1st August.
To the date. Okay, 1st August. Okay.
So 1 plus 6 is 7. Now you make a lookup table where you have to divide because there are 7 days in a week, right? If you divide by 7, whatever is the remainder, that will decide the day of the week. Now I'll tell you, 0 becomes remainder, it is Sunday.
Yeah.
1 becomes remainder, it is Monday. 5 becomes remainder, it becomes Friday. 6 becomes remainder, it becomes Saturday. You got all the days, right?
Okay. Right.
0, 1, 2, 3. So you got 1st August is your birthday. 6 is the code given. So 6 plus 1 is 7. So 7, if you divide by 7, remainder will be 0. So Kakoli's birthday is 2021. It is on a Sunday.
Okay. It's a 7 by 1. You did 7 by 7, right?
Yeah, 7 by 7, remainder is 0, na? No reminder.
Okay. Achha, no reminder. Okay. Got it.
Reminder is what determines that.
Yeah. Okay.
When I was a 9th class boy, I made this calendar. Not only for this year, I can make for 100 years and there is a repetition which happens. So, I can easily find out what will be on 2051, 2061 or any year.
This is crazy. Wow.
So January 26th, 26 plus 4 is 30. 30, when you divide by 7, remainder becomes 2. Because 28 is a multiple, na?
Yeah.
Of 7.
Yeah.
So, yeah. 2 remainder will become Tuesday. Now,
I'm happy to know that my birthday is on a Sunday though.
Now, if you tell this to young children, will they not start doing multiplication, addition, subtraction, remainder, finding out? All that will become a routine job for them. the maximum number of times you repeat it, it becomes simple for you.
True. Yes, sir.
Assume I want to multiply 26 into 22. Can you write 26 on the one side and the maybe on the top you write 26, on the left side you write 22. Make a square of 10 and 10. Divide the 22, no? 22 can be divided as 1 unit to 10, another unit to 10, another 2 units of 1, 1.
Yeah.
26 can be divided as 21 unit, 10 1 unit, 10 another unit, and 6 another small units. Yes or no?
Yes.
Now you got a box sort of a thing or a table sort of a thing where one 10 10 unit, another 10 10 unit, another 10 10 unit, another 10 10 units. How many 10 units are there? 4.
4, yeah.
And four. You have got 2 units on the bottom or maybe 6 units on the side. Correct. So what is 22 into 26? It's actually 20 into 20 plus 20 into 6 plus 20 into 2 plus 2 into 6.
Okay.
So 20 into 20 is 400. 20 into 6 is 120.
Right.
20 into 2 is 40. So 400 plus 120 plus 40 plus 12.
Right. 2, 2, 2, 3.
See, I did not.
72.
I did not draw, so I am drawing it now.
But yeah, yes.
You understood?
Yes.
400.
Yeah.
400, 120, and then 40. And 12. Yeah. 172. 572, right?
Right, yeah.
So you got the answer. Now what are you doing? Your multiplication, you are visualizing.
Right. Wow. Yeah. Okay. I learned so much in the Thank you.
So these days I am teaching BBA students one business communication skill in which mathematical communication. They have a paper called the corporate campus to corporate. How do you approach analytical reasoning, logical skill, in which I don't even write, I don't show PowerPoint. The way I am talking to you now, I keep on talking to them. I don't write. Teachers should not write in mathematics. Students should write. See, any other subject learning, there is a small saying. Have you seen 3 Idiots movie?
Yes, yeah.
Now, Madhavan, you know Madhavan, right?
Yeah, right.
Madhavan is also acting in that.
Yes.
Right?
Yeah.
Madhavan was an electrical engineer or some engineer?
Yeah.
Electronics.
Yeah, he was an engineer. Yeah.
And actually, Madhavan understands most of the things very clearly. That's why such movies, no, when they act, they understand things carefully. This man is also like that. Who? Amir Khan. Amir Khan in one of the movie took one myth from my poetry. I am an English poet.
Oh, wow, sir, and you are so talented.
And one of my friend who was a teacher in Delhi, there is a institute, film institute, where he was a teacher, media teacher.
Okay.
I gifted my book and he took that book into the class and then started reading. And that book is full of biology in the first poetry.
How?
Millions of sperm from the father get into the mother's egg. And only one sperm take birth, and that's me.
Right. Oh, that scene is there in 3 Idiots, yeah.
That is from my poetry.
Oh.
Race for birth is my poetry. Millions of sperm
Wow.
from the father get into the mother's egg, and only one sperm take birth, that is me. I fought with millions of unborn brothers and sisters before my birth. Kakoli also took birth like that. So now don't you feel like patting yourself and say, well done?
I do.
Each one
Yes.
of us are blessed so much, no? To have a beautiful hair, beautiful nose, beautiful teeth, beautiful eyes.
Okay.
See,
okay.
You know that the whole trouble of life, you know. Are we not blessed to have such a good brain where we are not using it?
Yes, it's true.
Acharyat padamadatte padam shishya swamedhaya padam sa brahmacharibhya padam kalakramena cha. Have you heard this anywhere? That is why you have seen Three Idiots, but you have not learned Three Idiots movie. In that, there is on the podium, when this sloka was chanted, everybody started laughing. And that sloka you must have heard, but you must never checked what is the original sloka, why people are laughing.
Okay.
You also laughed, right?
Yes.
I am also, I'm a film critic, so I look at film so carefully, looking at why people laughed.
Okay.
I'm curious to know what is wrong in that sloka, and why that sloka is picked up. When you look, see that sloka is picked up because the original sloka is Acharyat Padamadate. 1/4 of the learning comes from Acharya. Padam Shishya Swamedhaya. 1/4 has to be done by children themselves.
Okay.
Padam Sa Brahmacharibhya. Along with your friends, you discuss and learn, another 1/4 will come to you. Padam Kalakramena Cha. 1/4 you can learn only later part of your life with your own experience.
Okay.
But as far as mathematics is concerned, this is not true. Because in mathematics, 1/4 will not be taught by teachers. If you don't know mathematics, building mathematics becomes difficult. The base is essential. Any other subject, no problem. Including biology, chemistry, physics and all. Somewhere I can start from the middle. Mathematics, it is impossible. You will have to have the base first.
Yes.
So, how do I make my base? The 1/4 which I am supposed to learn by myself through discussions which I don't do, I lost that 1/4 in the childhood.
Right.
Therefore, I am losing all that step by step. It becomes difficult, 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 difficult. That is why mathematics becomes tougher. So, if somebody has to start learning mathematics, they should look at basic mathematics, build up again.
Right.
And for which 1/4 will not be given by teachers. You will have to invest more time. Maybe half you will have to invest yourself. Because you cannot discuss if you don't know anything. No? See, another subject you can discuss many things without even knowing. If I want to discuss about the politics of India, I don't require to know anything.
Yeah.
But mathematics, you have to be certain, no?
Yes, that's true. The basis is very, very important.
So, that is why in our education system, we will make people to pass. I keep telling, teachers are like doctors. They have to treat the patient before discharging. If I got a student in second class, I should conduct examination, which is also called a test. Which is happening in two places. One in classroom, second one is in medical laboratory. Examination or test. So assume that somebody says this and immediately you are discharged without even treating. What will happen? Your disease will become more. The teachers are making students to pass though they have got 60%, 50% also.
Yeah.
How can a doctor discharge somebody without treating properly? Similarly,
yeah.
teachers should not make some students to pass to higher classes without passing.
Right.
That is why mathematics becomes difficult.
Okay, sir. Okay.
You understood? So therefore, basic
yeah.
learning, it is not, it is your disposition. How much you dispose yourself into learning. How much you love. And learn to learn is more important than, I know I learn different subjects, but that's not important. I must learn how to learn this subject.
Right.
See, I am learning cycling. Is it to get a 35% mark in cycling?
No.
I am learning swimming so that, or cooking, so that somebody will give me 35%. I say, I am a cook. Am I happy? So it is not 35% mark for pass mark, 50%, 75% which is important. I must enjoy cooking, I must enjoy swimming, I must drive without scare.
Right.
I should not make my life miserable by cooking and driving and swimming. Same way, I should learn the subject, making my life so simple, not miserable. Now you understood the philosophy of learning which I am teaching maybe millions of students. This is
you should have the aptitude to learn, otherwise
yeah.
that is difficult to
So
yeah.
creating that aptitude and creating an attitude, creating your communication very good so that I know how to communicate in mathematics is more important. So it is not learning mathematics, it is imagining, visualizing, understanding. Learning is different and understanding is different.
Mm-hmm.
So how many teachers and how many students can do this? How many teachers can do this? How many parents can do this? Is what is important in today's world.
Right. Okay.
Probably
okay.
you never had a 1 hour mathematics class like this in your life, no?
I used to have when I was studying, but yes, but it's refreshing after so many days, understanding something with new eyes, that's really, really great. Thank you so much. And thank you for your time, sir. You told so many things, and I understand what you are trying to say, that, you know, people have to have the aptitude and also have to learn and visualize and imagine math to actually learn properly.
Most of my writings are on life.
Mm-hmm.
L-I-F-E,
okay.
life.
Mm.
Live in full enjoyment.
Mm.
L-I-F-E, life.
That's a good one.
Learn in full enjoyment.
Yes.
Learning is an investment for future earning.
True. Yeah.
L-E-A-R-N, learn. When you learn, you get a driving license, which is learning license. After learning, you have to cut your L. So that becomes earning.
Right.
My house is nearly 200-year-old house in Kerala.
Wow.
Which is called Jnanam. J-N-A-A-N-A-M. Jnanam.
Which place in Kerala, sir?
Kerala, North Kerala. Kannur. Close to airport.
Okay, okay.
It is close to new airport. There is a new airport, Kannur.
Okay.
Ezhimala Naval Academy, you know.
Yeah.
Ezhimala Naval Academy also, you don't know.
Mm-hmm.
That's almost like Assam. Assam only.
I've never been to Kerala, but when I used to see the pictures and
it's
all.
It's almost like Assam. So that's why when I go to Assam, I feel like it's my native.
Yes, the greenery.
Sir, right.
Thank you so much for this. I enjoyed a lot. Thank you so much. This was like a very surprising and refreshing thing. I was not expecting this, but this is really great. Thank you so much. And I really admire the passion you are taking in teaching.
Otherwise,
you.
What can I do in my life?
Yes, that it is great that, you know, you have a passion and you are actually spreading it among others. That's a great thing to do. Yeah, thank you so much for talking.
So gladdening, no? So you had the patience of listening. Some people, last year, almost the same time, 18th of today is 21st, 18th of December, I spoke like this. Just Manju made some story and then she found that that is not that appealing. She, I think she redone the whole page next day itself.
Okay.
And the impact is not that. Here, reading that, Eenadu fellow came running to my house for an interview. And that Eenadu, they have a Sunday magazine which published my story.
Okay.
And you know the contacts which I got, probably Indian Express doesn't have that much coverage.
Mm-hmm.
Though Indian Express published in Kochi, Bangalore and Hyderabad.
Yes, yes, our circulation is not great. Yeah,
yeah, all the three editions. Yeah. But Eenadu impact was so much, I had at least 20 people called from America.
Wow.
To take how to teach my children, no? And last year I was in US. So I had satsang for long time on different subjects. I do satsang on spiritual. Bhagavad Gita I just finished. So some of them were from these Eenadu people, they started participating my Bhagavad Gita satsang.
That's amazing. So we will take like little bit credit that at least, you know, they...
No, no, that's what I'm saying. I keep telling all of them. Otherwise, why should I tell you this now? I used to tell all of them, this is because of Indian Express. And yesterday only, you look at my Facebook, I posted to the Indian Express thing because last year, I remember this is the day. So I said last year, this date, I was in Eenadu, I mean, Indian Express. And now that is getting circulated in my whole students group because I did not post that last year in my Facebook. This year, I posted. So my BSc classmates who are my colleagues 35, 40 years back, they are circulating in all their groups now.
Wow.
Now they are writing,
oh, we also feel good about this.
You came in Indian Express like that. They started, you know, asking me. That's what I do. I already posted those two pictures to you.
That's, I am really glad to learn this. Thanks for sharing. That's really great to learn about this. Yes, so
Dhubri.
I grew up in Dhubri, but after that we shifted to Guwahati. So right now we are in Guwahati, but I grew up in Dhubri, then I came to Hyderabad.
My cousins who were taking care of the South Indian tea stall was the tea series cassettes, no?
Mm-hmm.
He was distributor. He was distributor for that when I visited him in 1990. 30 years back, I went to Guwahati. Those days, there was no mobile phone, no?
Yes.
And I was seeing my cousin brother probably. I was in 7th grade and he was in 12th grade or so. And I was meeting him when I completed my MSc, doing PhD time.
I
had a conference in the Guwahati University. So, he was telling, don't worry, I will find you. No digital contact. I was wondering, my train is reaching there from Hyderabad. How he will find me? Was my confusion. He said, don't worry, we have only one telephone online only, no mobile. You know what he did? As I reached Guwahati railway station, he was standing on the overbridge and shouting my name.
Oh my god. That's really, really funny.
Somebody,
very clever.
No?
How else would he have done it?
And I will give you one small link of my that cousin who used to be part of my camp in my hometown.
Okay.
He can sing song in 7 different languages, including Assamese.
Wow.
He was one of my closest cousin. I lost him last year. He was my strength because he was staying just opposite to my house. So what I used to do is, every camp he will come and my children, I will tell them 7 languages means they will tell, sing a song in Telugu, sing in Tamil, sing in Assamese, Bangla, Gujarati, Hindi, Malayalam, all languages. Instantly he has got. There may be some mistakes in the lyrics, but he speaks so well all those languages. He was called Das. He was Ram Das, but there he was called Das or Bangla.
People have such a knack for languages, they have. Yes, sir. Yes,
Yeah.
sir. I will. Thank you. Thanks, sir.
God
Yeah.
bless you.
Bye.
Enjoy.
Thank you, sir.